Hello Internet, I am Tessak and welcome to the third part of Developer Diary. Today we are going to look at graphics. And let's start with something that's not really graphics related. Let's start with drafts of UI. First of all, when I start doing something with graphics and there is UI into that kind of graphics, I like to make a quick draft. The draft is something that's going to save us a lot of time. And there are three huge advantages of doing drafts like this. First advantage is it allows us to think more about placement and dimensions of UI elements and the wall UI as one thing. It allows us to see if there is too much crowded area or there is something that's really empty or if there is too much text or too much icons or if there is something overdone, etc. The other point that the draft is going to help us make is that it allows us to make things consistent. Whenever I as a developer starts feeling lost or inconsistent, I can always go back to the draft and see where I made mistakes or where I started getting away from the original idea, etc. And in the end, it allows us to keep things consistent and really well organized. And the third thing that's really easier with the draft is quick experimentation. Let's face it, in Unity or other engines or other editing softwares, it's really not that easy to experiment with UI. You may, but it's always faster and quicker and easier to try these changes in graphic editor. It is. It's just selecting a tool, moving things around, adding something new, quickly looking at it and you know what needs to be changed. And if the idea that you had in your time is the idea that you had in your head is better or if you need to stick to the original idea. Anyway, enough about the draft. Let's focus on the icons because the video is about icons, right? And about the graphic, so let's focus on that. I decided to split the icons into two groups. First group is something that I like to call main icons, and let's focus on that for a while. The main icons are icons that are 64 by 64 pixels, and the job of these icons is to tell people that some element is really interactive. The players can click on it, the players can interact with it, and they can do stuff with it, basically. So, in that order, I made icon for housing, icon for workshop, two for campfire, and one for resource gathering. And I will explain each of them right now. The housing and workshop, let's explain them together, because they are the same thing, basically. I like to call these things basically group, and I draw icon for each of these buildings. I didn't make any icons for the rooms at facilities yet, and I will make them in the future. But right now, I don't feel like there is the need for it. Maybe we'll use some kind of placeholder or something like that, because I feel like I'm going to change something about the room in the future. Might be the name, might be the function. And as it is right now, I don't feel like we need to wait some time on drawing more icons. Well, I would like to draw more icons. I would really enjoy it, but I don't have the time to waste. So I decided to not risk it, and instead I made two icons for campfire and another set of icons that I would like to call info icons. But first, let's focus on campfire, because campfire is something that's very highly interactive or interactable for the player. First of all, the icon itself says to the player if the campfire is built, if the campfire is on fire, or if it is not on fire. And by clicking on it, the player can interact with it. The player can build a campfire, set it on fire, you get the idea. And the player is going to quickly get the information from the icon. So we just save something. We don't need to make an indicator for the campfire status beside the fact that we are going to swap the icon. The same thing applies in essentially the same thing applies to resource gathering as well. The icon is added to the game, or I made the icon and I'm going to add it to the game in order to experiment with it a bit. Because I would really like to make the activity selection bar a bit more interactive, a bit more, let's put it this way, easier to understand. So I was thinking about three icons over the activity selection bar that would represent the activities, and the player would choose between them, and the selected activities would be highlighted somehow. Well, we will see about that. We will try to implement that into the game in the future episodes. And basically, I hope you understood the idea. Well, let's focus on the info icons. The info icons are icons that are just here to tell something to the player, give him the information. These icons are smaller, they are just 32 by 32 pixels, and their job is to help the player understand the game. It's always easier for the player to look at the icon than read the text. So instead of saying wood, we will have a stack of timber. So the player, by looking at it, will just know, hey, that's probably wood. Instead of word stone, we are going to have pile of stones. So the player will be instantly like, hey, it looks like stones. And he will instantly know that the number in on the side of the icon of stones is probably the number of stones here. And that really applies to back to the resource gathering, right? And other activities that we are going to implement later. Well, the icons of activities implemented later. It also applies to the number of steps. But at the same time, the icon is smaller and it don't really imply that you can interact with it. At least in my head. And I hope that I think really similarly as most of the players, hopefully. Anyway, I think I covered everything that's icon related. Let's focus on something that I want to talk about a bit, but I don't want to talk about it too much because it, in the essentials, this is thing that I would talk about for wall video and it wouldn't be enough. Okay? And the thing is the style of the graphic that I choose. Well, quick answer why I did choose a pixelated graphic is that I really like making it. I like to draw pixelated graphic. That's the short answer. The longer answer is that I do really appreciate or admire old school graphics, especially from the 90s era, because at the 90s, the limitation of hardware became really not that. The graphics were no longer that much limited by hardware, basically. That's what I'm trying to say. The sprites could be bigger and larger. The space was no longer limited too much. And the colors could be, there could be more colors in single sprite than before. So the artist or the graphics guys from that era could do more with it. Still, they needed to assign each pixel a meaning, but now they could deliver some kind of something else, something more to the graphic, instead of just representing something. So, in my mind, the graphic from the era started looking really good. Well, way better than from the 80s, for example. And later, in the early 2000s, etc., the graphics developed, and, well, still, the graphic from the 90s is really iconical, I think, and I do really like to draw from the influence of it. I really like to get inspiration from this kind of era, and I do really like to put this inspiration into my work, and I always try to deliver something more. I'm trying to add something, something special, something new, came up with something something new for the picture, etc. Well, basically, this is the long answer for the style. And as we are approaching the end of the video, I really would like to thank you for watching, and hopefully I will release next video sooner than later, and until then, see ya!